Krishna, even though a lot of people saw this coming, it doesn't make it any less painful. And that's because UNLV football was poised for a big season with new coaches, a new training facility, and of course, the chance at playing right here at Allegiant Stadium.
Well, we may have a time of challenge right now. We're going to have that same momentum when we all get back together this spring.
UNLV Athletics Director Desiree Reed-Francois says that while COVID-19 may have put a hold on fall football, it won't block the momentum the school has in building up the program.
When it's safe enough for us to play, we still have an incredible new $2 billion Allegiant Stadium. We still have the best training facility in the entire conference, and I would say in the entire West Coast.
Not to mention a new coaching staff led by former Oregon offensive coordinator Marcus Arroyo, who says he is and will remain fired up.
Whenever they allow me to kick those doors open, we'll be ready.
Wide receiver Drew Techman says yesterday's announcement hurt, and he did feel confident in the school's ability to protect his health during the season. But he says the team will use this time to get better.
Continue with the momentum and keep pushing forward. When we can roll out the balls and play, we'll play.
UNLV officials say the pause will not impact any athlete scholarships. And because training facilities remain open for now, the majority of athletes will likely stay on campus. And while the uncertainty of the world has created new challenges in building a program, Coach Arroyo says recruiting season is open and they're hunting for talent.
On the move, there hasn't been anything that has slowed us down in regards to building a relationship or finding ways to do roster management or keep an eye on how things do. That doesn't mean we're sitting back here in the blind, not paying attention to kind of what we could see or forecast.
Now, again, those training facilities do remain open for now. So actually, the UNLV football team ended up working out this morning. They're hoping to have a fall training camp that would replicate a spring training camp and hopefully prepare them for an upcoming season. Reporting live, Jackie Kostek, 13 Action News.
Jackie, thank you.